Some student asked me yesterday, how is it feel in heaven? So I wanted to tell him, in heaven you feel like hell. Why you say you feel like hell? Because how can a person feel that he's in heaven if one of his brothers are still in hell? Can you call it heaven? It's hell. If you know that your brothers are suffering, if you know that your brothers are going through so many difficulties still, can you rest? Can you rest in peace? Can you feel like it's heaven for you? There was a righteous man, his name was Rabbi Israel ben Sara, and he said that when he's gonna go up to heaven, so he will not gonna enter into gates of heaven until he brings out, takes out all of the evil people from hell, or from Am Israel of course, and taking them with him straight to heaven. So they asked him, why? Those people deserve punishment in hell, and you're supposed to go to heaven. He said, how can I be in heaven when I know that one of my brothers are still suffering over there in hell? It's not heaven, you cannot call it heaven, it's hell. In the book Shara Gilgulim, I think, about Rabbi Chaim Vital, Rabbi Chaim Vital is telling, all that it's in the book Shara Kedusha to Rabbi Chaim Vital, Rabbi Chaim Vital is telling that when he had one of his visions, one of his dreams, and he saw HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and he saw the righteous people sitting in a circle around HaKadosh Baruch Hu, with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So he saw one seat was empty, so he asked, who's that seat? Who's that seat belongs to? So HaKadosh Baruch Hu answered to him, it belongs to Shmuel HaNavi. Shmuel HaNavi is not taking his seat in heaven until the complete redemption. And until then, he's walking around Jerusalem, surrounding Jerusalem, walking on the wall of Jerusalem, and praying and praying and praying that Mashiach will come, that the Geulah Shlema will happen. And he's not ready to enter to no heaven until all of Am Israel are going to be redeemed. That makes sense.